Alright. Y'all ready?
Let's do all this, right. Man.
Menuhin's movie pass. Let's go.
Hey. Hey.
I'm back.
Yay.
Hey.
Yay.
I'm back. Menuhin's movie pass. All right. Who's ready? Are you ready? Cause I'm ready to talk about them goddamn movies. On this episode, I watched Lovecraft Country. I watched Sneakerhead. And I watched a few other things. So tell 17 people. Let's go!
Alright, guys, before I jump into this episode, I read a disturbing article before I started recording this that said that 164 black people were murdered by police within the first 8 months of this year. Wow. I just want to take a moment just to reflect.
Gonna miss you. Tell me what went wrong. Gonna miss you.
I just want to take this time to say a few names off of that list. Some of these black people you've heard of, you've heard the news, and some you haven't heard of. I just want to take this time to let the families know out there, they're not forgotten. I just want to say their names. All right, let's get into it. Alton Sterling. George Floyd. Breonna Taylor. Xavier Williams. Desmond Hayes, Freddie Gray, Trayvon Martin, Albert Hughes, Ryan Sims, Tyree Davis, Ahmaud Arbery. Yeah, put your fist in the air for him. Yeah. All right. COVID-19, still real. Let's see what celebrities are doing, how they're dealing with it. Let's see how Chris Rock is dealing with what's his take on the COVID-19 pandemic.
One thing about COVID and quarantine and all this stuff, you know, I call this the three pigs part of life. Remember the three pigs?
Yeah,
you have to really figure out what kind of house have you made, Charlemagne? You make it. Is your life of sticks? Is it a
straw?
Is it a
brick?
Straw, yeah. Or bricks?
That's real. But you don't know that until something happens, though. America thought it was a brick house.
That's right.
So yeah. So did you make a brick house? And I tell you right now, I'm getting calls. Some of my friends have brick houses, but some of my friends' houses are made of straw. And I'm getting calls from famous people trying to sell me their cars.
Wow.
And like people we know that, like, get ready to lose their houses. Like, people that have been on the Breakfast Club that, like, yo, the houses are falling. So, yo, this is the time, you know, nothing to be ashamed of, but, you know, from this point on, we know something can happen.
Yeah.
And we should live our lives accordingly.
Well, with that said, is there any of those people that you want to be the big bad wolf to? Because they fucked you over in the past?
Blow the house down.
I'm not blowing nobody's house down. I wish everybody well. You know, when this thing went down, you know, the first thing you do is like, how do I take care of the people I love? How do I take care of my loved ones? How do I make sure they're safe and secure and can, you know, weather this storm? So, and I'm blessed, you know, and I'm not the most religious person, but thank God I can like help out, you know, my people. So
this is
truly a blessing.
Three little pigs. Yeah. Yeah. That is so true in some ways. As far as it does, this whole thing does make you think about the foundation you've built as a person, you know, male, female, whatever, you know, like what have you built for your family? What have you built for yourself?
Is it brick strong? Is it sticks? Is it kind of wobbly? Or is it straw paper thin where it's falling apart? And this is definitely a clear example as to it could fall apart and you need to be ready in whatever way possible. So we need to all have some money stacked. Like I got money pushed aside, stacked, waiting for stuff like this. So I pretty much fell on a nice little cushion. But, you know, if this pandemic lasts too much longer, it's gonna get weird. So, yeah, definitely stay healthy, guys. Keep wearing your mask. You know what I realized? Me and my girl went to a birthday party, right? Now, I've noticed, like, I've been to a few, like, group kind of settings, like birthday parties, and I went to an outside wedding. And what I realized is, once the food comes out, the masks come off for good. Food, I'm telling you, every time I've been, people were standing around, they'll show up with the mask, with the gloves on, they have these face visors, all this, come through looking like Sub-Zero and Darth Vader, just, what's going on, man? How you doing, man? All of that, and then next thing you know, as soon as a snack comes out, like, oh, well, what is this? Take the mask off. Oh, let me take a taste. Oh, this tastes amazing. The next thing you know, the pandemic is forgotten. So, hey, just watch yourselves, guys. Watch yourselves. I got a trip. I got to go to San Diego to visit my little brother and his new baby. I got to see what he created. And I'm not going to lie. I got to fly. I'm meeting my mom out there too, and I'm kind of on edge. I don't know. Being on a plane, that's what, world bacteria? I don't know. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. Just be safe, guys. This pandemic is starting to feel like a hoax every now and then somebody dies and then it brings us back. So it's back and forth. I know COVID-19 is real, but you know, in my neighborhood, it's cool. I don't see nobody dying, but in some places, people are dying by the packs. So I don't know, guys. Keep your mask on. Stay safe out here. Protect your older family members. And let's get into some movie news stuff that I was pulling up. I read that John David Washington, which is a weird name. Well, not really. Well, I don't know. For some reason, John David Washington. It sounds like a Confederate soldier, but he's not. That's Denzel Washington's son, which Denzel Washington's son, John David Washington, he hid it from us for years and didn't want to let people know he was the son of Denzel Washington, which I understand because Denzel is freaking dope. But he wants to play Reed Richards in the new Fantastic Four. Come on, bro. Man, just let the white people have this one, man. We want John Krasinski. We don't want anybody else. We want John Krasinski and we want Emily Blunt as the Invisible Woman lady. And I don't know who they're going to do as Torch or the Thing. I mean, they could do, for all I care, they could make DMX the Thing. Oh my God. It's Carmen time. What? Like, if yo, that would be, yo.
That real shit, bro.
I am campaigning for DMX to play.
Butterfly in the sky.
Come on!
I can go twice as high.
Let's get it on.
Take a look.
Nigga.
In a book.
My nigga.
Reading rainbow.
You think it's a game?
I can go anywhere.
Suck my dick.
Friends to know.
My nigga.
Yo. Could you imagine that? He's like, what? It's clapping time. Oh my God. Oh man, that would be so funny. Ah, God. And you know who I would want to play? No. I was gonna say Ryan Reynolds, but nah. You know, it needs to be somebody just like a wild card to play Johnny Blaze, like Shia LaBeouf or Brad Pitt. That'd be random as hell to have Brad, but you know, he's got to be a younger dude. Anyway,
I'm just, but DMX as the Thing would be amazing. What else is in the news? Henry Cavill is gonna, looking like he's gonna be playing Superman again and back to James Bond. I don't know what the whole thing was with him not playing Superman. I don't know what that was about, but I have noticed since COVID hit, he's gotten a lot more movie roles. I guess he snapped out of it. He was like, well, shit, I need to take all the movie roles I can get right now. So, like, he's gonna play in Superman. And what happened to Idris Elba? What happened with that? Like, you know what? It would be hard for a black dude to play James Bond, because James Bond usually fights crime in predominantly white areas. So, black dude is already, black is already suspicious. So, to have us running around, you know, I'm born to James Bond, shaking not stirred, seeing all these things like that, like, who the fuck is this black dude talking about shaking not stirred? Yo, arrest this man. Like, he would be arrested so many times. A black James Bond. I want to see a black James Bond. But I'm just saying, he would be arrested a lot. Like, MI6 would be like, God damn, that's the third time today he's been arrested. Police have been shooting at him a lot. 164 times the police have tried to kill him. Okay, that was, okay. Anyway. That was a callback to what I said earlier. Anyway, so yeah, I want Idris Elba to be him, but it's just like, it's easier for a white dude or a white woman, but nobody wants to see a white woman play James Bond, because they would lose their freaking mind. Oh, James Bond is supposed to be a man's role. Ugh. James Bond is a spy. It could be 007, it could be Jane Bond. Like, the black chick that's in this new James Bond movie, she is kicking ass. The clips that I've seen of this chick, killer. And matter of fact, who is it? The girl that played in Columbiana. She played Gamora. I can't think of her name right now, but she's amazing in an action situation. All right, now I'm going too far. I'm trying to make James Bond a black woman or a white woman. I'm just saying, it doesn't have to be a white dude. It could be a white woman, or it could be, I mean, because women could get into anything, you know what I mean? It's just black men, we get locked up. We gotta break out of jail. Every James Bond movie will be Idris Elba trying to break out of jail to get back to the mission. He's like, I'm trying to get back to the mission, but they won't let me. They keep locking me up in the fucking penitentiary. Like, it would be that all the time. So, what else? What other news things that I read about? Avatar 2 and 3. God damn. He's almost finished with 2 and 3? Usually people finish one and then go to the next. I mean, do we really want to see Avatar again? I feel like he waited too long. I don't know. I don't have any interest in seeing Avatar 2 or 3, but it's been delayed due to the COVID-19 situation, and Avatar 3 is supposed to be coming out in the year 2024, which I don't know how he can call that, because, you know, we don't know what's what now. Also, Black Panther footage has leaked. I don't know. I mean, I went to look for it, and it's just like a piece of his costume or his outfit. So it was kind of like, all right. And I heard some more footage leaked or something like that, but I don't know. You know what I'm hoping? I'm hoping they filmed a large chunk of the movie, or maybe they filmed the whole thing already and we don't know, and it's Chadwick. And man, I swear, if they filmed it and I see Chadwick on that screen as T'Challa, I am gonna tear up in the movie theater. I'm not lying. I'm not trying to be like, yeah, man, I'm show respect. I'm being in the movie theater like, Chadwick. I'm telling you, I'm gonna cry like a little bitch. last but not least, Masters of the Universe. People are dropping fan art. I heard they're supposed to be making the He-Man movie. Who is that for? Is that for us? Is that some type of nostalgia? You know what it is? It's another nostalgia move. And I don't give a damn to see it. I had He-Man action figures. That's like the late 80s, early 90s type of kid. Do we really want to see it? I mean, the first He-Man movie was weird. I still don't feel like that was an actual He-Man movie. with Dolph Lunger and whoever the hell else is in it. But I didn't miss it. I'm not like, yo, I can't wait for another He-Man movie. Like when the Ninja Turtles came out, I was like, yo, I can't wait to see the new joint, which turned out to be a Nickelodeon cartoon movie, but I couldn't wait for it. But who is waiting for it? I feel like they're gonna ruin it. I don't know. Just like Disney keeps ruining all of our childhood cartoons and shit with their, like they got a new Tinkerbell. They made it a black chick from Blackish. And I'm like, you're gonna ruin another class. Okay, anyway, let's move on. I watched a few things. This is far into the podcast to be talking about the damn. Anyway, it don't matter. Look, guys, I watched The Boys, and The Boys season 2. I watched the latest episode, and damn, that show was so freaking good. Like, I'm not gonna talk about it just yet. I'm just gonna say how I feel, but I'm not gonna talk about it just yet because I'm waiting till the whole season. When the whole season ends, I'll probably hit my boy Love up and a few other folks, and we'll have like a conversation about it. We'll talk about it. But I want you to check it out. If you haven't seen the first season, binge the first season and then start watching the second season, because this, I like, it's one of those shows that you just can't call unless you, they have the comic and the graphic novel series of it in which you can get elements of it or whatever. But if you haven't read that, like I haven't, and you just watch this show, you don't know where it's gonna go. Like, it got really, really racist. This last episode was like, yo, what? Hold up. What just happened? So it's always evolving, always ever changing. And I like it because I don't know where it's gonna go next. And a lot of things are happening and it causes me to yell at my screen like, yo! So it's, The Boys is something to watch, yo. I recommend it. The Boys is dope. I also watched Sneakerhead on Netflix, and it's starring King Batch, the internet star guy, and a few other people. And you know what? The only thing interesting about that show is the sneakers. You know, you like, because I'm not a sneakerhead per se. Like, I'm not out there just buying them. Like, I admire the sneakers. Like, I look at sneakers like porn sometimes. I'm like, yo, look at these. Look at the butt cheeks on them Jordans. Like, I'm always looking at sneakers. Sometimes I may buy a pair here and there, but I'm not the type to be like, yo, the so-and-so's just dropped. I gotta get those. I gotta cop the new Jordan 3089s. They got the fin on the side and they got a fax machine in it. Yo, the new Jordan 2058s got the fax machine and the scanner in it. I gotta get them. Like, I'm not that dude. I'm that dude about technology. Like, if I see a new gadget, whew, I love gadgets. But yeah. So the sneakers are cool. The sneakers are interesting to look at. The knowledge and the history on sneakers. Like, I could just watch a documentary on the sneakers in itself. But it's not that. It's a TV show. And it's just the same cycle of story. It's like, you got the guy that, he used to be a sneakerhead, now he's a family man. He wishes he can get back into it. He misses it. His best friend is still in the game and causing his responsible friend to spend a bunch of money and mess up his life slowly because he's trying to get back or get that sneakerhead fix again, and he keeps messing him up. So it's just like the continuous, it's like a Pinky in the Brain type of story. Just keeps, it's the same setup and it keeps happening. And yeah, story's kind of weak, but sneakers are interesting. So, I mean, that's just what you got to look forward to if you're going to watch that show. It's aight. What else did I watch? Oh, I watched Lovecraft Country. Let's get into the ratings. Rotten Tomato gave it 87%. The people on Rotten Tomato gave it 67%. IMDb gave it 7.2 out of 10. And overall, Google users gave it 93%. And this show is another example of, we can't scare black people or have black scary movies without a dash of racism. So, we just can't have vampires and monsters and zombies. We gotta have racist vampires, monsters, and zombies. We gotta have slave zombies and white people experimenting on us, and we come back from the dead to avenge the deaths of our ancestors. It's one of those. It's all of that wrapped in a nice, tightly wounded piece of racist bacon. It's a lot to take in. This show, wow. You guys are going to have to bear with me, because I feel like this review of this show is going to be all over the place. First of all, I recommend it. I watched 7 episodes straight. I think they were an hour each, I believe. I don't know. It was. I really couldn't tell. I was just so into it. It's a lot of different stories. Okay, there's one through line story, and then there's a bunch of stories, like small stories in between, like a Tales from the Hood, Tales from the Crypt type of situation, mixed with Civil War, racism, monsters, and magic. A lot of magical white people. And it's good. I like it. It has a good energy of black empowerment, but also has some history involved in it. It's mainly about this one guy, and he's related to this masonry type of family somehow. And it's a bunch of spells and magic and stuff that's connected to him. And he's on this journey trying to figure out parts of his family ancestry and how it connects to this whole thing. The first episode is wow. It starts off really racist, then it ends up with a bunch of monsters ripping people's heads off, and then they end up in this mansion of magic and stuff, and it just gets weirder and weirder. It's one of those shows where you can't tell where it's gonna go at all. Like, one episode was fully in Korean, and it just takes place when the main character was overseas in this Korean War, and he met this woman, and she ended up being this legendary, well, he didn't know it at the time, but she ended up being this legendary myth of a beast called I forgot the name of it. It's a fox that has 9 tails, and usually takes the form of a beautiful woman or something like that. And there's a whole situation to that, and then that leads into the main story. And then there's this other story that breaks off from the main story, where this black woman, she goes on this journey through space and time, and she discovers who she is, and she realizes that she's basically been making herself smaller due to just the racism she's dealt with and just the life that she's lived. It's so deep. Like, episode number 7, it's called I Am. Holy sh! That episode took me to a whole different level of just I can't explain it. I can't explain. It was so good. Like, I want to watch it again to better just understand some parts of it. It was just, I don't know, it felt good to watch. It was very empowering.
There's this one episode where this black woman, she's like a blues singer, and she sings in these late night clubs and everything, but she wants to work downtown at this boutique type of place. And it's just white women and just white. And they won't hire her because she's black. And then she goes there one day just to check it out, and she sees a black woman got hired. She's confused, she's pissed, she's kind of jealous, but she doesn't hate on the chick. She's just like, how come I didn't get this opportunity? But then
she meets this white dude. White dude gives her, he bangs her, yeah, but he gives her this power to become a white woman. She jumps in, becomes this white woman, and she works at the store, and they give her a management position because she's a white woman. And then she is working with the girl, that the black chick that she saw earlier. And you know what I liked about it? The fact that she wasn't trying to tear her down as a black woman. Like, she wasn't, like, because she was pissed off the fact that she got the job and she didn't when she was black. But she was like,
even as a white woman, she was still trying to build her up. Even though black chick was messing up a little bit, she was trying to build her up like, yo, you need to be better than these white people. You need to be the best black person you can be. Like, she was really building her up, and I really like that about that character. Because that's something my mom has always told me. You always got to be better than just, you have to be the best that you can be. There's no half-assing as a black person. This is what my mom told me. There's no half-assing as a black person. You have to be the best of the best. So when you show up to a job interview, you have to look sharp and pressed. You have to have your shit together, your resume. You can't have no flaws. And that's a lot of pressure. Because I remember going to job interviews and seeing dudes, white dudes, with like Converse on, khakis, and like a wrinkled up shirt, looking like balled up homework, just kicking it. And I'm in there with a suit, a briefcase. I had cufflinks on. I had a briefcase with just my resume in it. Like, that's, I think, a resume and a PB&J. Like, always top notch. And that's just how it, that's just how it always has been for me. And it's all, and I like the way she described that in the show. She said that to that black chick. So she turns from a black chick to a white chick, and then she has a potion where she could turn back. It was, that's a whole nother episode, but that's also connected to the main episode. And then the dude's dad is gay, or he's trying to hide it. And that was another episode within another episode. Like, it has so many different layers. This show is so layered. It's hard to explain what the hell it is. I will say it's very sci-fi with a little bit of Indiana Jones, a splash of racism, a lot of zombie stuff, black people going through some crazy shit. It's a lot. I will say that it's a lot of different things every episode. You will not get bored watching this. Like, I just watched the last episode. The last episode that's available, which is episode 7, called I Am. And that was crazy. So I recommend it. If you want to see something that's unpredictable, like The Boys, or, you know, like any other thing that I've named that's really unpredictable, this is definitely a show that I recommend you check out. Because I've seen like commercials for it, I've seen like posters up for it, and I was just like, all right, let me just check this joint out. And it's interesting. Very interesting. And a lot of history kind of woven. It's like it's history woven in between, and it's well done. I like it. I will say I like the show. I'm sorry. I feel like I'm very all over the place, but it's that's what the show is. It's all over. It's controlled chaos, if that makes sense. Like, it's like, it's chaotic. It's like, oh, what is this that, but it's a through line story, and it held my interest. I mean, I watched 7 episodes of it. I think each one was an hour or something, hour or so long. So it's something I recommend. So there you go. Lovecraft Country, recommended. What else? The Boys, season 1 and 2. If you can watch it, if you got Amazon Prime, definitely check that joint out. Because that is, that show is forever changing. And it's dope. Sneakerhead on Netflix. I don't give a. Sneakers are cool, but the story is like, what? What are we doing? So, don't recommend that. And yeah, that's about it. Definitely, you know, stay safe, guys. Whatever you're doing. You know what episode? My fault. Go back to Lovecraft real quick. The episode with the skin tone change. Like, I've had conversations with my friends about that before. We've all talked about, like, what if we could change the contrast of our skin? Like, back in that time, I feel like it was way crucial, because if they found you in just anywhere near a white town, they would just try to kill you. That's what it looked like. And I would love to, I mean, right now, I think I would only use it for, like, speeding tickets. Like, if I'm driving speeding, I would just turn the tone up and be like, how are you doing, officer? I can help you. And then just, you, back to black once I drive off. But I don't know, having that power to just change your skin tone, ah, man, You know what another thing is about that show? I've realized white people are super creative with their hatred. Holy shit. Like, there's an episode where this black chick moves into this white neighborhood, right? And the white folks in the neighborhood park their cars in front of her house. And they tie bricks to the horns of their cars, so they just constantly honked. So you got a brick tied around the steering wheel with rope, and it's just going beep in front of their house, just all night, all day. I'm like, wow, that is crazy. And then, you know, they burned a cross and all the other stuff, but it's just like, damn, I would have never thought to do that. Like, yo, let's tie a rope around a brick and annoy the shit out of them until they leave our neighborhood. So yeah, anyway, I keep talking about it. Definitely check out Lovecraft Country if you can. It's on HBO. And that's it. Check me out at mmpass3000 on Instagram, mheart3000 on Instagram, and also check me out on Menuhin's Movie Pass on Facebook. The group is growing. Hit me with a request. I'll bring you in. It's a fun group. A lot of cats is talking junk about movies. You know, it's fun. I post stuff in there. People post things. It's a nice time. And yeah. So you know, get money. Be safe. Look out for your loved ones. And I don't know. Eat celery. Eat vegetables. I don't know. I get awkward at this part of the podcast. So I don't know what else to say. I love y'all. Thanks for listening. I appreciate y'all. I really do. Tell 17 people, as I usually say. And I am out. Bria, bria, bria.